Good morning and welcome to worship. I have a couple announcements for you, but before I do that, I want you to be thinking if there is anything that you would like to celebrate, any names to lift up for a celebration or a prayer request. And then also we are doing God moments, anything that you would like to share with the people of how God has been involved or shown up kind of in your life in this last week, you are welcome to share that as well.
I'll start.
All right.
My daughter, Libby, turns 25 tomorrow.
Yes, Libby turns 25.
My daughter, Libby, who is, so I'm going to be 25 tomorrow. And
yes,
I'm still 37. I'm not sure how that happens.
You promiscuously over.
Just stay over there, you big, you perfect twin.
All right. I have at least one announcement for you. We are doing the baptism today of Sidney Ruth Kelly. And so that's where the flowers are from. We're given by her grandparents for that celebration. Yesterday we had the tailgate sale, and this is for anybody who might have been here earlier this week or earlier in the service, and then new for everybody. But we counted everything, and we have almost just shy of $500 that we made as a tailgate. So that will all go towards our current funds, so the current giving. Next Sunday is Reformation Sunday, and so you are all invited to wear red to represent the Holy Spirit, and then also kind of that as a special day to remind us when Martin Luther nailed 95 theses to the church door. And this year, Reformation Sunday falls on Reformation Day, October 31st. And so it is October, it'll be 504 years, something like that. So in 2017, it was 500 years ago. And then on November 7th, we are doing All Saints Sunday. And so you are invited to turn in anybody's name, those you would like read aloud during the prayers of the people, of those who have died in the last year. And I will say the name, and then we will ring a bell after each of the names as kind of a remembrance of their life. Are there any prayer requests or other announcements or any God moment that anybody would like to share? Yes?
Mary.
Mary?
Mary
Morrison. Okay. Yes.
I just wanted to say this is the bottom line for me that my family, those parents here, wonderful.
Yes. So it's so fun to see all the friends and family. Yes. That is the bottom. All right.
I would like to ask for prayers for the eyes and hearts.
Okay. Any other prayer requests? If there are no prayer requests, I invite you to stand as you are able for our call to worship.
God is much more than we could ever know, and that is a good thing because most days we'll take all we can get.
The soul needs to return. We can't just fill it once. It needs to be filled regularly.
Our gathering hymn today is Romans 12, verse 1.
Father, Son, Spirit,
It is with the spirit of the resurrected Christ that we greet one another, even with our pain, with our fear, with our celebration as we share the peace. Today, I invite you to stand and greet those around you by sharing your name and the words, "Peace be with you." As God's beloved people, made radiant by the light of Christ, let us pray for the church and the whole human family and God's good creation. Lord, you are the God who is simple, direct, clear with us and for us. You have committed yourself to us. You have said yes to us in creation, yes to us in our birth, yes to us in our baptism, and yes to us this day.
When you love someone but it goes to waste.
It's who we love to let it go. But if you never try, you never know just what you're
please stand as you are comfortable. The Holy Gospel according to Mark, the 10th chapter.
Lord, to you, Lord.
Jesus and his followers came into Jericho. As Jesus was leaving Jericho, together with the disciples and a sizable crowd, a blind beggar named Bartimaeus, Timaeus' son, was sitting beside the road. When he heard that Jesus of Nazareth was there, he began shouting, "Jesus, son of David, show me mercy." Many scolded him, telling him to be quiet. But he shouted even louder, "Son of David, show me mercy." Jesus stopped and said, "Call him forward." They called the blind man. "Be encouraged. Get up. He is calling you." Throwing his coat to the side, he jumped up and came to Jesus. Jesus asked him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man said, "Teacher, I want to see." Jesus said, "Go. Your faith has healed you." At once, he was able to see and began to follow Jesus on the way. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. Along the road, Many things can happen along a road. A little more than 500 years ago, we heard and we remember Martin Luther and what he was doing along a road. He was out traveling and he got in a rainstorm, and all of a sudden he cries out to Saint Anne saying, "Saint Anne, save me. And if I live, I will become a monk." So we all know how that story ends, right? Martin Luther was saved, and then he became a monk. And so today we have another person along a story, along the road, crying out for help. We have Bartimaeus. He is sitting beside the road, worried about his life. But he is also going to do something about it. We hear that he is calling out for help. But what does the crowd do? Shh! Be quiet! Don't call for Jesus. But what does Bartimaeus do instead? He gets even louder. He says, "Son of David, show me mercy." And here Jesus hears him and calls him forward. And so the crowd now is encouraged, and they say, "All right, you get up. Jesus is calling for you." And so we hear that Bartimaeus jumps up, throws his coat down, and goes to Jesus. Last week, we heard the story of James and John. They were asking Jesus, "Jesus, can you do something for us?" And Jesus was like, "Well, what do you want me to do?" Right? But here, Jesus, Bartimaeus is just saying, "Help me, help me." He's saying what he wants Jesus to do. But we still get the question from Jesus, "What do you want me to do for you?" So Bartimaeus says, "Teacher," or in the Greek, he says, "Rabbi," "Rabuni," "teacher, I want to see." He knows exactly what he wants. In my pastor's corner in the announcements, I used that verse and I said, "How would you answer that question? If Jesus were to come up to you and you had just been saying, 'Jesus, Jesus,' and Jesus is like, 'Yeah, what do you want? What would you like me to do for you?' Would you have an answer right then?" I don't know if I would. Even if I was being like, "Jesus, Jesus, help me." That's kind of a thing that we say, right? But Bartimaeus could have said many different things. We knew, according to scriptures, that he probably was able to walk because he jumped up and was able to go over. But he could have said many different things. But he said, "Jesus, I want to see." A few chapters earlier, we hear of another healing story where Jesus is healing another blind man. Except for this time, we don't hear any questions of consent, of "What do you want?" In the story of before, the friends of the blind man come and bring him to Jesus. And then Jesus takes the man by the hand and leads him outside of the village, spits on his eyes, lays his hands on him, and says, "Do you see anything?" And the guy's like, "Well, I see these things. I think they're people, but they kind of look like trees wobbling to and fro." So Jesus does it again. He spits on him, puts his hands on, and then the man is able to see. But the thing that I have been noting and kind of thinking about this week about our healing story for today is that question. What do you want me to do? Today we are going to be doing a baptism. And as a part of that, I will ask Marcy and Michael of these questions. Do you promise to do these things for Sidney? Do you promise to teach her the Lord's Prayer, teach her the Ten Commandments, give her a Bible, do all these things? The last part is, will you work for justice and peace? To me, if Jesus were to ask that question after this week, after I've been thinking about, that's what I would want. I would want justice. I would want peace for the world. I would want everyone to know that they are loved. But I would want it also in consent, saying, can I touch you? Can I do this thing for you? What do you want me to do? So as this week, as we go, I invite you to think about your answer to that question. What do you want me to do for you? What would you like Jesus to do for you? Or even how would you ask that question to others? What would you like me to do? And then listen for the answer. So may we go along this road, this way, as it says, hearing about Jesus, asking questions, and encountering one another. Amen. I would like to ask Sidney and family and everybody if you would like to come forward to the baptismal font. And if there are any other kiddos who don't really fit with our heart but want to come up and see, or maybe if you're feeling young at heart and you want to see what's happening, you know, I'm not going to judge. You're welcome. But so, yes, so if I can get at least Sidney and Marcy and Michael and the godparents to come forward, and I'll meet you down here, and Pastor Dexter, who is also going to be a part, to meet me over here at the baptismal font. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Christ. We are united with all the baptized in the one body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission for the life of the world. Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, do you desire to have Sidney Ruth baptized into Christ? If so, say, I do. All right. And so as you bring Sidney to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with these responsibilities: to live with her among God's faithful people, to bring her the word of God and the Holy Supper, teach her the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, place in her hands the Holy Scriptures and nurture her in faith and prayer, so that she may learn to trust God, proclaiming Christ through word and deed, care for others and the world God made, and to work for justice and peace. So I ask you, Marcy and Michael, do you promise these things to help Sidney grow in the Christian faith and life? And if so, say, I do.
I do.
All right.
Godparents, Matthew and Francesca, do you promise to nurture Sidney in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help her live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church? If so, say I do.
Yeah.
People of God, do you promise to support Sidney and pray for her in this new life in Christ? If so, say, I do.
I do.
I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God, the powers of this world that rebel against God, and the ways of sin that draw you from God? If so, say I do.
I do. So with the whole church, let us confess our faith. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and returned. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
to give thanks and praise. We give you thanks, O God. Right in the beginning, your Spirit moved over the waters. By your word, you created the world, calling forth life in which you took the light. Through the waters of the flood, you delivered Noah and his family. And through the sea, you led your people, Israel, from slavery into freedom. At the river, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death and raise us up to live with you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of the living word, that those who are washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
So I invite you to put her head over. Sidney Ruth Kelly, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You belong to Christ,
in whom you have been baptized.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through the water and the Holy Spirit that you give your daughters and sons new birth, cleanse them from sin, and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Sidney with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and light, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever.
Amen.
Sidney Ruth, child of God, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the sign of Christ forever. Amen. You have been clothed in Christ. All who are baptized in Christ have put on in Christ. Walk in the faith of Christ, crucified and risen. Shine with the light of Christ. Through baptism, you have been received into the household of God, entrusted with the good news of Jesus Christ, and strengthened to serve by the Holy and life-giving Spirit.
And the mission each share. Join us as we give praise to God and bear God's creative and redeeming work to all.
Sidney Ruth Kelly, the newest member. Look at all the new friends. Yeah. Please stand as you are comfortable, and we will sing River of
Oh,
God be with you all.
And also with you.
Rejoice. Christ promises to meet us in this meal.
Our hearts are filled with joy and expectation.
Our Lord Jesus, the night before he died on the cross for us, took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his friends, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you." And again, after supper, he took a cup of wine, gave thanks, and passed it to his friends, saying, "This cup is the new covenant, sealed with my blood. All of you drink from it and know your sins are forgiven."
As we eat this bread and drink from the cup, we remember Christ's death and the promise of his coming again.
And let us pray as Jesus has taught us.
Thank you.
the body of Christ given for you. The blood of Christ shed for you.
May the life-giving power of God free us to dare us to live differently, to play and work as people who have been transformed.
We go as the people of God, taking the risk of following our risen Lord, accepting the challenge to love and be loved.
Please stand as you are able. We led our benediction. If there's anybody else who would like to join Mason, grow up.
May the Lord bless and keep you.
May the Lord bless and keep you.
Make his face to shine upon you.
Make his face to shine upon you.
May he always be with you.
May he always be with you.
Give you peace.
And give you peace.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Son.
In the name of the Son.
In the name of the Spirit.
Our final song today is Blessed Be Your Name.
Your name, the Father, God is blood to fold. peace, the journey continues.
Thanks. Thanks.